What's up everybody and welcome back to the channel and to another Outriders video. A little bit of a different content package today. We're not going to be discussing any of my builds, but rather look at the two builds which People Can Fly have revealed via their Twitter account for Outriders, the Infinite Reaper and the Arctic Avenger. We do have a third one, the Revenant, still coming. And I'll just basically discuss my thoughts on this, what I think worked from it, what doesn't work so much, and just generally share my thoughts with that. But this is absolutely a very interactive idea that I'm working with here, so I want you to go into the comments, tell me what you think of those builds, if you've built them, if you're impressed by certain parts of it, and just in general what your thoughts are. But if you do enjoy the video or you find it useful in any way, do consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, maybe sharing the video with a buddy. It really does help the channel grow and it just means a whole lot to me. But without any further ado, let's jump right in. So, the Infinite Reaper and the Arctic Avenger. These builds, straight off the bat, I can say that from an aesthetic perspective and how they created these build videos, I really, really like the format. I like how they are put together. The editing is top notch. But just generally, the editing from People Can Fly when it comes to their trailer material for the game has always been really good, has always been really catchy and, you know, really captivating. So, I definitely can't fault them for that. But I somehow feel like this translates to these builds as well, because my feeling is that they're more built for an aesthetic or a look rather than function. So built more for form than function. And it's not clear to me which CT they were playing these builds on, but the way that they are built right now, and this is true for the Infinite Reaper and the Arctic Avenger, is that, you know, you have a good spread of mods, you have a good spread of abilities, and it certainly is an interesting idea of a build, but when it all comes together, it is not basically in its best form. And so therefore will probably, or not probably, I happen to know people that have tested it, of course, and I've looked at their source material. Shout out to Cloudplays, for instance, for doing this. Those videos are fantastic to check out, so definitely do have a look if you want to see someone that is actively actually playing with these builds and trying to make them work or offer some good critique on them. But the basis here for me is that you could potentially make these builds work, but in their current form right now, I just think that they're a little bit lacking, or I found them lacking. And you're only really going to notice this when you get later on in the CTs, where you have just insane health, you know, scaling of mobs, as well as their damage increasing. And likewise, if you play these in a solo environment, they're probably going to perform a lot better than they do in a co-op three-player environment. And this is basically very easy to see if you just look at the Arctic Avenger, which just takes a real serious amount of bullets to actually drop enemies down. And this is of course compounded by the fact of enemies having more life when you get later on in the CTs, but also when you add more players into the mix. And so inherently there lies the problems that these will probably perform very well against, you know, weak CTs starting out. And to showcase this kind of thing, but as a fully functioning end game build that you can use to farm content very efficiently, not talking about doing it in a specific time, but just doing it from an efficiency perspective, so it's not too difficult to play, you're not going down the whole time, you're not struggling for like a half an hour to clear a room, this is probably just not going to cut the mustard. Now what is interesting to me is that I think that People Can Fly could be using this as a vehicle for them to sort of test sharing builds, and maybe this is the precursor to them starting to lean out to content creators and asking them to submit their builds. What I think would be super interesting is opening up this challenge to people and saying, you know, submit your build with, you know, like your little description of how the build works or something like that. Keep it under 2 minutes, make it spicy, and we'll rate like the best ones and we'll put them up on Twitter and we'll have these compete against each other. And in the end, we'll have like the Devastator that the most people voted for made by this creator, and we'll have like the Technomancer that the most people voted for made by that creator. And I definitely think there's a very fun interaction that you can have with your audience. We're certainly all very passionate about this game, and one of the big things with this game is finding a build, making it work, swapping mods out, and then, you know, realizing that you've come up with something special. It really is kind of the main reason for playing this game, at least for me. So again, just to summarize, I think that this is also them just testing out bringing this level of content to the game and what the reception is for it. I definitely, of course, people are being like super cruel and saying, you know, like, you know, do people can fly, you know, do you lift, bro? No, I'm joking, but do they even play their own game? And do they, you know, actually understand how these builds work? And I absolutely think they do. This could also be a vehicle for them to just, you know, test a format of introducing new sets, introducing new weapons. And certainly they will be testing some of these things as we are now working towards the paid DLC, which is coming out hopefully early-ish 2022, but that's not really revealed yet. But if they were to reveal new armor sets or a new class or new mods or new skills or new weapons or anything like that in this format, I'm sure it would be a massive success, because like I said, aesthetically it's incredibly pleasing and it's very well presented. That's pretty much my thoughts on it. As I said, pretty underwhelming. They have one left, the Revenant, which kind of makes it seem like it's probably gonna be, I guess it's gonna be a trickster, right? So I feel like Pyro is gonna be the odd one out that's gonna get left out this time around. But the Revenant's probably gonna be a trickster. I don't imagine it's gonna perform any better than these other two. And so it's gonna be more about looking cool than rather, you know, punching really hard or cutting really hard or shooting really hard. But let's give it a try. Let's see when it comes out. One last thing I do want to say though, and this is where the PSA part of this really comes in, and that is that, of course, when it comes to the players in this game, you kind of come down the middle where you have like the OGs, the people that like myself that have stuck around since the beginning of the game. And so by now we've accumulated tons of mods, we've accumulated tons of gear that we can use those mods on, and we have multiple versions of, for instance, the same build or the same gear, so that we can really experiment around. The one thing that is a little bit for me like an iffy point about this is, by having a build like this featured on your socials and like sort of out there for new players to see, and with this massive influx of new players that have come in and recently bought the game to the price cut, and you know, because of the new Horizon patch being out, there is just a part of me that is concerned with the fact that you can fully commit to this gear and mod something into it where you could have used those pieces for something else. And you might be thinking that you're building something extremely spicy, only to realize that it's actually not that great, and therefore you've now, you know, for instance, used some of your Borealis pieces and you've modded them in a way that you now need to go farm new Borealis pieces. That's a small complaint, something small that I can leverage against it, because not everybody has the time to sit and punch 8, 9, 10 hours into the game, get as many dropout resources as you can, pick up as much gear as you can, get multiples of something. So this might cause to a select group of players in this game, it might cause some frustration to them when they realize that they've built this and it's recommended by people can fly, so surely this must be good shit, only to realize that, nah, it's kind of okay, but it definitely is not like like smoking hot when it gets to the late game. So that's like a little thing, but I mean, again, to me, this is not such a big issue, and if you like playing the game, then you know, it's not that big of a bother. You can just refarm the gear. But I do know that some people value their time obviously a lot more than maybe I do. And so this might be a little bit of a catching point. But that's it for the video. Thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments down below, like I said, what you think about this whole thing. What you think about the builds. Am I being too hard on them? Am I being too soft on them? Who knows, right? But let me know what you think of it. Let me know if you've tried them out. Maybe I'm missing, you know, maybe I'm missing something that's making them so super sexy and hot. Or maybe you've taken one of these builds and you've made it work. Really, really interested to hear that as well. But that's it. Thank you so much for watching, especially if you made it this far. It is super important to me that you have a fantastic morning, a great afternoon, and a super awesome evening wherever you are in this world. And until next video, fucking cheers. They want the best of me now. Best of me now, best of me now, best of me. They want the best of me now, best of me now, best of me now, best of me. They want the